Hello everyone, welcome to StudyIQ. In this video, now before I start this video, you can follow me on Instagram and I want to connect with you all on a more personal level. So that is usually not possible on Facebook or YouTube. So you can connect me on Instagram or on Twitter. So that is my handle. I have yesterday only made an account on Twitter. GauravGarg888 is my account. Now in this video, I will cover third week part one current affairs. And this will be important because IBPS PO mains is just around the corner and I have covered around 85 questions in this video. If you are preparing for SSC Bank PO or UPSC, our sale runs till 23rd November midnight. So grab one if you have the resources. Otherwise, you can make use of free videos which are as good. Now, a good news, StudyIQ has been voted as the best education channel in India and Andhra Pradesh government. The government of Andhra Pradesh has given us this honor. And I've just back from Vijayawada and I've got this award. So a really big thanks to all of you. Now in my last video, I told you that wildlife sanctuaries are very difficult to remember because they are a lot in number. And that is why in every video, I am covering one state's wildlife sanctuary. Now in my last video, if you recall, I covered Madhya Pradesh's 25 wildlife sanctuary. And in this, I will cover Karnataka. Karnataka is a very, very important state for wildlife because it has highest number of tigers and highest number of elephants in India. By the way, elephant is the state animal of Karnataka. So it's a beautiful state. I've spent 6 years in Karnataka and it's on the Western Ghats, which receives one of the highest rainfalls in India. So these are the wildlife sanctuaries in Karnataka. Arabithittu Wildlife Sanctuary, Bhadra, Bhimgad. Then there is something known as BRT Wildlife Sanctuary. In short, its full form is Biligiri Rangaraswamy Temple Wildlife Sanctuary, Melakote Temple Wildlife Sanctuary, Jayamangali Black Buck Reserve. Black Buck is a very, endangered animal. Renabenur Black Buck Wildlife Sanctuary. So these two are for the Black Bucks. Daroji, this is for Bear. Daroji Bear Wildlife Sanctuary. Mukambika Wildlife Sanctuary, which also has a shrine of the Mukambika Devi. I visited this place too. Nugu Wildlife Sanctuary, Pushpagiri Wildlife Sanctuary. A few more. Shravati Valley Wildlife Sanctuary. Now, Shravati is a very important river because this river forms what we call Jog Falls. It is one of the highest falls in India, Jog Falls, made by Shravati River. And there we have Shravati Valley Wildlife Sanctuary. We have Shetty Halli Wildlife Sanctuary, Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary. This is a bird sanctuary. Another bird sanctuary, very important that they ask in exams, is Dr. Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary, which is in Goa. Now, remember, Dr. Salim Ali National Park, it is in Jammu Kashmir, but Dr. Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary, it is in Goa, so don't get confused. Dr. Salim Ali was a renowned ornithologist, which means a bird scientist. Someshwara Wildlife Sanctuary, Tal Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary. Remember, there is a sanctuary called Kaveri Wildlife Sanctuary and there is Tal Kaveri. And Tal Kaveri is the place from where the river Kaveri takes its origin. There is a Kaveri river water dispute between Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. The river takes its origin from Karnataka and then goes to Tamil Nadu. There is Attivari Bird Sanctuary. There is a Mandagadde Bird Sanctuary. Bankapura Peacock Sanctuary. This is for the peacocks. And another sanctuary for peacocks is the Adi Chunchanagiri Bird Sanctuary. It is again for peacocks. Bonal Bird Sanctuary, Ghat Prabha Bird Sanctuary. Now remember, Ghat Prabha is a very, very important river. It is a tributary of River Krishna. And River Krishna's tributaries are very important. They are asked in exam because there is a tributary of Krishna called Musi. On the banks of Musi River, we have Hyderabad, capital of Telangana. And another river that is a tributary of Krishna is Koyna, which flows in Maharashtra, mainly Satara region, and there is a Koyna Dam. So the Koyna is also a tributary of River Krishna. Then we have Godavari Bird Sanctuary and Magadi Bird Sanctuary. Now let's start the video. So which state government has launched a center of excellence for data science and artificial intelligence in collaboration with NASSCOM? Now remember, NASSCOM chairman is Raman Roy. Important. This state is Karnataka. And their budget for the same is 40 crore or 400 million rupees. So the answer is Karnataka. It has Banargatta, Bandipura, Nagar Hole National Park and Anchi National Park, Kudremukha Tiger Reserve, which was declared a tiger reserve in 2013 along with Rajaji Tiger Reserve of Uttarakhand. And it also has Dandeli Wildlife Sanctuary, which is also a tiger reserve. Karnataka Chief Minister is Siddaramaiya and Vajibhai Wala is the governor. Consulate General of which country has launched a youth entrepreneurship initiative which is called Y for Biz, which means youth for business, in 4 cities of East India: Guwahati in Assam, Patna capital of Bihar, Ranchi capital of Jharkhand and Kolkata capital of West Bengal. So this has been done by the American government. And remember that Mr. Kenneth Juster, he is the American ambassador to India. And also remember that Global Entrepreneurship Summit is about to take place and Donald Trump's daughter Ivanka Trump will attend that. She will head the American delegation for the same. Donald Trump's wife is Melania Trump, and defense minister is James Mattis, and secretary of state, also called foreign minister, is Mr. Rex Tillerson. What is the name of the world's first virtual space country which recently launched its first satellite into the space? This is a world's first virtual space country. It is called Asgardia, and it is a project by Russian scientist and billionaire. His name is Igor. Now this is important. Ashurbaili. Igor Ashurbaili is the name of the scientist whose project is Asgardia. It's a virtual country, and Russian space agency is called Roscosmos, but this satellite was not launched from Roscosmos but by NASA. So Russia's capital is Moscow, and Russia has Red Square. It's an important place. Russia has St. Petersburg, which is a very beautiful place. They have their own church, the Church of Russia, and that's the Eastern Church. And also Russia's president is Vladimir Putin, who has become the first Indian player to qualify for the prestigious CME Group Tour Championship on the LPGA Tour that was held in Naples. Now Naples is in Italy. Italy's capital is Rome, and it has the headquarters of World Food Programme and Food and Agriculture Organization. Italian Prime Minister is Paolo Gentiloni, and Italy has the highest number of UNESCO World Heritage Sites, 36 are in India. Italy has 53, and her name is Aditi Ashok. Now in the exam, they also ask SSP Chaurasia. He is a male golf player, so remember his name also. International Students Day, it was recently celebrated on which date? It was first celebrated in 1941 in the capital of England, London. So the answer is November the 17th. London is located on the bank of a river which is called Thames River, and it has a square which is called Trafalgar Square. It is in London. And then you have the Times Square, which is in New York in America. Red Square is in Russia. Tahrir Square is in Egypt. As per a study by Netflix, the online streaming company, what is the rank of Indian viewers on the public binge watching? What is binge watching? So for example, let's say you are watching a serial. I used to watch Prison Break when I was young. So Prison Break, now you watch one episode, then you will, you won't wait, right, till the next episode. So you will start second, then third. So when you watch one episode after another, that is called binge watching. So some people, they kind of finish the entire season in one night only. Some have that habit. So what is the rank of Indian viewers in binge watching? Well, Indians are second to Mexico only. So Mexico is number one, India is number two. And who is the CEO of Netflix? They can ask this. He is Reed Hastings. Our Navy Chief Admiral Sunil Lamba, he has released the Joint Training Doctrine Indian Armed Forces 2017. It is a first of a kind document which is created for which force? Army, Navy or Air Force? It is created for all of the above. Army Chief is Bipin Rawat. Navy is Sunil Lamba, of course. Air Chief is B.S. Dhanoa. And remember two of the Indian ships, which is INS Satpura and INS Kadmat. They recently went to Japan. So INS Satpura and INS Kadmat. International Solar Alliance, it has announced to add 1000 gigawatt of solar power across the globe with an investment of more than 1200 billion euro. What is the deadline for the same? The deadline for the same is 2030. Now remember, India's deadline for renewable energy, India's target actually is till 2022, India wants to add 175 gigawatt of renewable energy. And our renewable energy minister is R.K. Singh. He is also the minister for power. Who has been awarded the 2017 Rashtriya Bal Kalyan Award? Rashtriya Bal Kalyan Award. Bal Kalyan basically means, when welfare of the children. Bal means child. So his name is Anand Kumar. He is the founder of Super 30. Super 30 is a coaching institute which provides education free of cost to the poorest of the poor. And he launched it in Patna, capital of Bihar, in 2002. Which country has announced to simplify its visa rules for Indians from January 2018? Which country I'm talking about? This is our friend Japan. And Japan's Prime Minister is Shinzo Abe, who has been recently elected in Japan again. And capital is Tokyo. Currency is yen. One Japanese dominated bank is Asian Development Bank, in which Japan enjoys the maximum share. It is headquartered in Manila, capital of Philippines. So Japan wants to make visa process very simple for Indian. Now, can I ask you a difficult question? Which country's passport is the most powerful? India is 75th on the list, and Afghanistan's passport is very, very poor. So Afghanistan's passport is the least powerful. But which country's passport is the most powerful in the world? Uber. Uber, the cab aggregator company, Uber has opened its second engineering facility in India at which place? They have opened it in Kondapur in high-tech city in Hyderabad, the capital of Telangana. There's a Batukamma festival in Telangana. Also remember that Telangana first language is Telugu and the second official language is Urdu, recently declared by Chandrasekhar Rao, the CM, and governor is Mr. E. L. Narasimha. Now remember, in Hyderabad you also have the Char Minar and the Lumbini Park, where there is a Hussain Sagar Lake also in Hyderabad. There's Ramoji Film City. Now Uber CEO is Dara Khosrow Shahi. Earlier it was Travis Kalanick, but now it is Dara Khosrow Shahi. And one more thing I was saying, yeah. Uber opened their first center of excellence in India also at Hyderabad. First center of excellence and second engineering facility at Hyderabad. Which country has launched the world's first ship? Now this ship, you just need to charge it for 2 hours with electricity. It is the world's first all-electric ship. That means it runs only with electricity and it can travel 80 kilometers with a 2000 ton load and only on a charge of 2 hours. This ship has been built by China and they launched it in the Guangzhou province. China's president is Xi Jinping. Beijing is the capital where headquarters of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank is there. And there is a co-finance project by Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank and World Bank, which is the power project for Andhra Pradesh. National Green Tribunal has constituted a committee of experts for the developing and assessing the infrastructure at which religious site? This is the Amarnath Shrine in Jammu and Kashmir's Greater Himalayas. Now my second question for you today. Recently, National Green Tribunal put a cap on Vaishno Devi for the number of passengers per day. How many passengers or how many pilgrimage can visit Vaishno Devi in one day? What is the limit set by NGT? Write down in comments. NGT chairman is Justice Swatantra Kumar. Which union minister has recently launched the National Power Portal, which is developed by National Informatics Center? This is basically a single point interface for all the power sector applications. It was launched by the power minister R.K. Singh. Piyush Goyal is the minister for coal and railway. Dharmendra Pradhan for oil and gas and skill development. Suresh Prabhu is our commerce minister. Union government has approved setting up India's first. This is India's first mega coastal economic zone. Where will it be set up? It will be set up at the Jawaharlal Nehru port, which is also called Nahava Sheva. This is very important. Nahava Sheva. It is in Maharashtra, very near to Mumbai port. Deen Dayal port is the other name for Kandla port. And Mughal Sarai station has also been named after Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay. National Press Day. It was recently celebrated on which day? National Press Day is basically, it was for setting up of the Press Council of India in 1966 on this day. That is why we observe it on November the 16th. 2 days after the birthday of Jawaharlal Nehruji, and World Diabetes Day also is on November the 14th. Now, important thing is that the chairman of Press Council of India is Justice Chandramouli Kumar Prasad. Chandramouli Kumar Prasad. Don't confuse Chandramouli with Rajamouli, who was the director of Bahubali movie. First ever World Health Organization Global Ministerial Conference on Ending Tuberculosis. It was held where? This is an important question. It was held in Moscow. This is the first ever conference for eliminating tuberculosis. Now let me tell you two, three very, very important questions. India's target for ending tuberculosis is 2025 and India's target for ending malaria is 2027. Okay, but WHO's target for ending malaria is 2030. So India wants to end malaria 3 years earlier than the WHO target. Now WHO president or director general is Tedros Adhanom from Ethiopia and deputy director general is Soumya Swaminathan. It is headquartered in Geneva. India's first Global Tribal Entrepreneurship Summit is going to be held where? Who is our tribal affair minister? His name is Jual Oram. And he is a Lok Sabha MP from Sundargarh in Odisha. India has a very significant tribal population. And it was held at Dantewada in Chhattisgarh, which is a Naxalite affected area. And it was inaugurated by Y.S. Chowdhury. So he's a union minister of science in science and technology. And our science and technology cabinet minister is Dr. Harshvardhan. He's also the Minister for Environment, Forest and Climate Change. He is a Lok Sabha MP from Chandni Chowk in New Delhi. So the answer is Dantewada in Chhattisgarh. Chhattisgarh's Dr. Raman Singh is the CM and Balram Das Tandon is the Governor. Which organization has bagged the second prize in the category of Social Contribution in Country Value at the ADIPEC Abu Dhabi International Petroleum Exhibition and Conference that was Energy Awards 2017? It is Andhra Pradesh Mineral Development Corporation. Now in Andhra Pradesh, the cleanest city as per the cleanliness survey was Vishakhapatnam. It ranks 3rd, Tirupati ranks 9th. Now Tirupati airport has been renamed as Lord Venkateshwara Airport and Vijayawada airport has been renamed to NT Rama Rao Amaravati Airport. And Vijayawada is the 19th cleanest place in Andhra. And Andhra Pradesh CM is Chandra Babu Naidu. There is a Polavaram project in Andhra Pradesh going on. Kuchipudi is the dance. Remember all these things. There's a Papikonda National Park here. Amaravati is the new capital. Okay. Who inaugurated the Hunar Haat at the India International Trade Fair, which is basically for skill development for minority community, basically artisans and their works. It is organized by the Ministry of Minority Affairs. He is our Minority Affairs Minister. His name is Mukhtar Abbas Naqvi. Who won the women's trap event at the 61st National Shooting Championship? It was won by Shagun Chaudhary. Also remember one more shooter, Hina Sidhu. And also remember one more, Jitu Rai. Hina Sidhu, Jitu Rai, they won the gold medal at the ISSF World Championship also recently in the 10-meter pistol event. Which state recently hosted the first edition of its hot air balloon festival at Araku Valley? Araku Valley. So Araku Valley, if you know where it is, this question is very, very simple. It is in Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh has Araku Valley. World Philosophy Day. It is celebrated every year in November on which day? World Philosophy Day we observe on the third Thursday of every November. This time it was on 16th of November. Which state government has launched a plan to become a plastic-free state from March 2018? This state is Maharashtra. There is a dance called Lavani Dance. Devendra Fadnavis is the CM of the coalition between BJP and Shiv Sena. Then Maharashtra has Gugamal National Park, Navegaon National Park, Chandoli National Park, Tadoba National Park, Sanjay Gandhi National Park and Fansad Wildlife Sanctuary. It has Jaitapur and Tarapur nuclear power plant also. Now remember when I talk about nuclear power plant, there is a nuclear power plant called Mithi Verdi. It has been shifted from Gujarat now to Andhra Pradesh. Andhra Pradesh Agro-Technology Summit, AG Tech Summit, was recently held and the theme was Progressive Farmer, Smart Farming. It was recently held at which place? It was held in the cleanest city of Andhra Pradesh, which is Vishakhapatnam. Now remember, Vishakhapatnam has the cleanest railway station in India, but it is the third cleanest city in India. So remember, don't get confused between the two. Agriculture Minister is Radha Mohan Singh. He is a Lok Sabha MP from Purvi Champaran in Bihar. Who won the NT Rama Rao National Award for the year 2014, 15 and 16, again given by the government of Andhra Pradesh. 2014, it was won by Kamal Hassan, 2015 by K. Raghavendra Rao and 2016 by the great Rajinikant Thalaiwa. So the answer is B. Who has been appointed as the chairman of the Bombay Stock Exchange? Earlier it was Mr. Dhirendra Swaroop. Now he has been replaced by Setu Ratnam Ravi. Setu Ratnam Ravi is the new chairman of Bombay Stock Exchange, which is the oldest stock exchange in not just India but Asia. And Mr. Ashish Chauhan is the managing director and CEO of Bombay Stock Exchange. But the chairman is Setu Ratnam Ravi. Abdul Manan Hossain. He passed away. He was a politician associated with which political party? He is associated with Trinamool Congress. Now earlier he was a member of Indian National Congress. In fact, he was an MP also in 2004 and 2009, but he had a clash with INC, then he joined Trinamool Congress. Now, Trinamool Congress is the ruling party in West Bengal. Mamata Banerjee is the chief minister. KC Nath Tripathi is the governor in West Bengal and it has Neora Valley National Park. There are four valley which you need to remember. Neora Valley National Park, it is in West Bengal. Pin Valley, Himachal Pradesh. Kangar Valley, Chhattisgarh and Silent Valley, Kerala. The fourth global conference on the sustained eradication of child labor was recently held where? By the way, who is India's labor minister? See, earlier it was Mr. Bandaru Dattatreya, but now he is not. Now it is Santosh Kumar Gangwar. He is the labor minister in India. So it was held at Buenos Aires and India was represented by Women and Child Development Minister Manika Gandhi, who is a Lok Sabha MP from Pilibhit in Uttar Pradesh. Buenos Aires is the capital of Argentina. Indian Navy has signed a contract with which company for supply of portable diver detection sonar under the buy and make category? This is for supply of portable diver detection sonar. And our defense minister is Nirmala Sitharaman. The company is Tata Power Strategic Engineering Division. Tata chairman is N. Chandrasekharan. President Ram Nath Kovind, he became the first president of India to visit the Indian National Army's memorial, which is located in Moirang. Where exactly is Moirang? It is in Manipur, capital is Imphal. And Manipur, Maricom is from Manipur, Irom Sharmila is from Manipur, and Mr. Pradeep Kumar, the HIV positive bodybuilder, is from Manipur. Manipur has Loktak Lake also. So that's all you need to remember about. And also remember that it is basically a replica of Indian National Army's memorial that was originally built in Singapore. And Singapore's president is, she's the first female president in the history of Singapore, Halimah Yacob. And prime minister is Lee Hsien Loong. Moody's Investor Service. Moody's is a credit rating agency, just like Standard & Poor's and Fitch and all that. So Moody's Investor Service has raised India's sovereign credit rating from BAA3 to what? And the more important is they have changed the outlook from stable to positive. This is very important. So they have raised it from BAA3 to BAA2. This is the first time they have done it in 13 years. Now, if they ask that why they have changed this, they are saying that because of JAM. J stands for Jandhan, A for Aadhaar, M for Mobile, and because of GST, and because of recapitalization of public sector bank, there is a good environment in India now for the business. Which bank has partnered with the Innovation Center of Denmark, which is called Innovation Center Denmark India, to bring financial technology innovations and startups from Denmark to India? Why Denmark only? Because Denmark is the first in global innovation index. That is why. This bank is Yes Bank. Rana Kapoor is the managing director, headquartered in Mumbai. Petroleum Ministry has announced to roll out Bharat Stage 6 fuel in Delhi. It is the cleanest fuel available and it is similar to Euro 6 fuel. And earlier they were saying we will launch it in 2020. But seeing the poor condition of Delhi with respect to pollution, they have started to launch it in April 2018. And this fellow is our oil and gas minister. His name is Dharminder Pradhan and he is also Minister for Skill Development. Former Supreme Court Judge V. Khalid, he passed away. He served as the Chief Justice of which High Court? Chief Justice of which High Court? He served as the Chief Justice of Jammu Kashmir High Court. Jammu Kashmir has Kishtwar National Park, Dachigam National Park, Hemis National Park, and Salim Ali National Park. Not Sanjay Gandhi. Sanjay Gandhi National Park is in Maharashtra. Jammu Kashmir also has Rauf Dance, and NN Vora is the governor. Mehbooba Mufti of the PDP party is the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir. Which state has topped the 5th biennial hotel event state ranking survey for tourism? Our tourism minister is KJ Alphonse and our culture minister is Dr. Mahesh Sharma. Which state has topped it? It is Delhi. It is a union territory, not exactly a state. And top 5 are Delhi, Maharashtra, Goa, Tamil Nadu and Gujarat. Which country has hosted an international conference or meet on buffaloes? It has been launched by Nepal. Capital is Kathmandu. Now let me ask you a very difficult question. There is a dam that Nepal was building for China with an investment of $2.5 billion. Now they have cancelled the project and it's like saying no to China. Which dam I am talking about? Similarly, there is a Mytson dam that was supposed to be built in Myanmar. It was a dream project of China. Myanmar said no. Mytson dam in Myanmar and this particular dam in Nepal. So those are two no's for China and India can surely tap into this anti-Chinese sentiment. So Nepal's president is Bidya Devi Bhandari and Sher Bahadur Deoba is the prime minister. Capital is Kathmandu, which is the headquarter of SAARC countries. Which of the following has been named Travel Plus Leisure's 2017 Destination of the Year? It is Canada. Defense Minister is Harjit Singh. Capital is Ottawa. And it has Montreal, which is the headquarter of World Anti-Doping Agency. And Justin Trudeau is the prime minister. Which company has launched Bharat 22 Exchange Traded Fund? It is basically to raise money. They will invest in the Standard & Poor BSE Bharat 22 Index. This company is ICICI Prudential AMC and they want to disinvest. So they want to raise around 8,000 crore rupees from the same. ICICI president is Chanda Kochar. Which institute has launched India's first in-house blockchain laboratory? It has been launched by the Bombay Stock Exchange Institute, BSEI. Which state has topped in opening the new Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana accounts after demonetization, which was done on 8th of November 2016? This is Uttar Pradesh, the state with the maximum population around 22 crore. And one-fifth of the 5 crore accounts that were opened after demonetization Jan Dhan were in Uttar Pradesh. So they were around 1 crore accounts. And Uttar Pradesh CM is Yogi Adityanath. Governor is Ram Nayak. And remember, Uttar Pradesh has Dudhwa National Park. It also has Naroda Atomic Power Plant. Who headed the working group? Basically, this is a report about how we can reduce the commodity price risk. Reducing the risk is also called hedging. So this is regarding hedging of the commodity price risk by residents in the overseas market. So you have to tell which person was made the head of this working group. It was Chandan Sinha. President Ramnath Kovind has recently launched Rs. 1500 crore Johar Yojana in which state? Johar has a full form. It is called Jharkhand's Opportunities for Harnessing Rural Development, in short, Johar. So the answer is Jharkhand, capital is Ranchi. Dhoni is also from Ranchi and Jharkhand. Well, Raghubar Das is the CM, and there's a lady called Draupadi Murmu. She is the governor of Jharkhand. Now Jharkhand has Palamo Tiger Reserve and Betla National Park. Which bank has tied up with Paytm to jointly launch interest-free short-term digital credit, which will range from 3,000 to 10,000 rupees only? So it has been done by which bank? ICICI Bank. And again, Chanda Kochar is the president of this bank. And as far as Paytm is concerned, Vijay Shekhar Sharma is the founder, and it is owned by a company called 197 Communications, that is the parent company of Paytm. And Paytm Payments Bank MD and CEO is Renu Sati. Which state has become the first among the northeastern states of India to launch point of sale for electricity bill payment? Now you can do electricity bill payment through point of sales machine in Nagaland. Nagaland has a very famous hornbill festival, and it has Intanki National Park. Kohima is the capital of Nagaland. T.R. Zeliang is the chief minister. Governor is Padmanabha Charya. Indian Railways has launched India's largest time-bound upskilling exercise for the employees. So basically, Indian Railways wants to upgrade the skill quotient of the employees. More than 13 lakh employees will be skill trained, and this project is called Saksham. Saksham. Who is the chairman of the railway board? Ashwani Lohani, and Rail Minister is Piyush Goyal. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu has recently released a book called Journey of Women Law Reforms and the Law Commission of India, Some Insights. Now, KK Venugopal is the Attorney General of India, remember that. And this book is written by which person? It is written by legal expert Dr. Pawan Sharma. What are the partner states of Madhya Pradesh under the Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat Yojana? What are the partner states? Partner states are Manipur and Nagaland. So the answer is 3 and 4. Madhya Pradesh has Panch, Panna, Bandhavgarh. All these national parks are there in Madhya Pradesh. International Day for Tolerance was recently celebrated on which day? And it is observed on November 16. It's a direct question, just mug it up. UN Peacekeeping Defense Ministerial Conference was recently held where? UN Peacekeeping, who is the Director General? Who is the head? Jean-Pierre. He's a French person. This is pronounced as Jean-Pierre Lacroix. And it was organized in Vancouver, which has a very significant Indian population. By the way, it is in Canada. There is a tribal festival which is called Adi Mahotsav. It was recently inaugurated by Vice President Venkaiah Naidu, and the theme was a celebration of the spirit of tribal culture, cuisine and commerce. Where was it inaugurated? It was inaugurated at Delhi Hut in New Delhi. Maharashtra state government has got the approval for how many irrigation projects worth more than 10,686 crore rupees? Total, there are 107 projects, basically for Vidarbha and Satara and Marathwada region, which are basically very, very dry. Which state government has announced a project to install Wi-Fi in all the Gram Panchayat? And in the first phase, in more than 2,500 Gram Panchayat, it will be installed. So, Minister of Communication is Manoj Sinha. And which state I am talking about? It is Karnataka. Which Indian woman won the Miss World 2017? R is missing here. After a gap of 17 years. And before this, in 2000, Priyanka Chopra had won it. And we all know how successful career she has had. So Manushi Chiller is the answer. She's from Haryana. And also remember, the first Indian Miss World was in 1966. And her name was Dr. Rita Faria. And she is also MBBS student. She will also become a doctor very soon. Who has become the first Asian to be appointed as the ambassador of the World Packaging Organization? It is Mr. ABPS Chakravarti. He is a owner of a company which is called Eco Bliss. It is located in Hyderabad. Which state government has announced to raise 25,000 crore rupees for developing a cow breeding center with the help of Patanjali Group, owned by Swami Ramdev and Acharya Balkrishna? This state is Maharashtra, and they will do it in Vidarbha at a village called Heti village, and Patanjali will purchase 10,000 cows also. How is India ranked out of 60 countries on the Climate Change Performance Index by German Watch, NGO German Watch? India is ranked 14th. India improved 6 places. China is ranked 41st. Now here is something interesting. German Watch did not give rank 1, 2 and 3 to anyone because no country did enough to combat climate change. So nobody deserved to be on the podium. And the 4th position is by Sweden, capital is Stockholm. Which of the following expressway will launch free Wi-Fi? It is Agra to Lucknow Expressway. Agra to Lucknow Expressway in Uttar Pradesh. and Lucknow Metro is the first metro in India to have their own FM. There is a wave-powered navigational buoy which is indigenously developed by the National Institute of Ocean Technology. It was launched at which port in India? It was launched at the Chennai port in Tamil Nadu. Now remember, Haldia is a port in West Bengal. Paradeep is a port in which we are buying, you know, the shale oil from America. It is coming at Paradeep port. And Kandla port is renamed as Pandit Dindyal port, Upadhyay port. It is in Gujarat. Which state has signed a memorandum of understanding with Patanjali Group for setting up a food park? And this will be with an investment of more than 10,000 crore. This state is Telangana. Railway Ministry has said that in all the trains of India, there will be bio toilets by which date? What is the deadline? The deadline is December 2018. And this was announced at COP23. There is a report which is called India State Level Disease Burden Report and technical paper. Which of the following was responsible for 15% of the total disease burden in 2016? So of all the diseases we have had in 2016 last year, what was responsible for 15% of the total diseases? It was malnutrition. Malnutrition. And among all the Indian states, Kerala has the lowest malnutrition. Sergio Ramirez, he won the 2017 Cervantes Prize, which is basically the highest literary award for Spanish writers, for literature in Spanish. And he is from which country? He is from Nicaragua. Capital of Nicaragua is Managua. President Ramnath Kovind, he inaugurated the first edition of a two-day Northeast Development Summit. Where it was held? It was held in the capital of Manipur, Imphal. Now remember, there was a 12th Northeast Business Summit that was recently held in New Delhi, and Manipur was the partner state in that. So Northeast Development Summit and Northeast Business Summit are different. Northeast Business Summit, it was the 12th, it was held in New Delhi recently. Manipur was the partner state, and Northeast Development Summit was held in Imphal. Which exchange in India has launched BEST Best? It is a trading solution built with the help of Thomson Reuters ominous Nest platform. It is Bombay Stock Exchange once again. Now there is another Watson platform of IBM. It is artificial intelligence platform that they ask in exam. Who has topped the list of Asia's richest family by Forbes, and the wealth is more than $44 billion? So it is the Mukesh Ambani family, and it is the richest family in Asia. The Lee family of Korea, South Korea, is second richest. Kwok family is third. Kwok family is of Hong Kong. Jagdish Mohan passed away. He was a famous what? He was also referred to as Sangeet Sartaj. He was a singer. Which country has recently become a signatory of Paris Climate Agreement? It is Syria. Capital is Damascus. Bashar al-Assad is the president. Now remember, America is the only country in the world which has not signed Paris Climate Agreement. There are 196 countries. 169 have signed. Only 27 remain. And these 27 have also signed, but they are yet to ratify it due to their domestic obligations. So America by will is the only country in the world which has not signed it. Which country is going to host the 2023 Rugby World Cup announced by World Rugby Federation? World Rugby is headquartered in Dublin. Dublin is the capital of Republic of Ireland. And don't get confused between Republic of Ireland and Northern Ireland. Northern Ireland is a part of UK. Republic of Ireland is a separate country altogether. So this is France. France will host it. And chairman of World Rugby is Bill Beaumont. France's president is Emmanuel Macron of the En Marche party. And Paris is the capital, which will host 2024 Olympic Games, and it is the headquarters of OECD and UNESCO. Kumar Narayan passed away. He was a famous what? He was a famous poet. He had won Padam Shri. He was a Sahitya Academy Award winner. And one of his books, which is very famous, is called Chakravyuh. Government has launched Saubhagya web portal, which is to monitor the progress of which government scheme? It is called Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana. Kevin Liliana, she has won the Miss International Award at the 57th Miss International Beauty Contest that was held in Tokyo, Japan. She is from which country? She is from Indonesia, and she is the first woman to win a beauty pageant contest from Indonesia. Indonesia, capital is Jakarta, which is the secretariat of ASEAN countries. Who has recently been appointed to the Financial Stability Institute Advisory Board by the Bank of International Settlement, which is based in Switzerland? He is Urjit Patel, RBI Governor. Who is the first woman in India to become a lawyer, whose 151st birth anniversary was celebrated recently? Her name is Cornelia Sorabji. She is also the first woman from India to study in Oxford Institute. And she studied in 1892. She is the first woman to graduate from Bombay University. She is the first Indian woman to study at a British university. She is the first woman in India to practice both in England and India. So a lot of firsts to her name. So Law Minister is Ravi Shankar Prasad. which state assembly has passed the Prevention and Eradication of Inhuman Evil Practices and Black Magic, Anti-Black Magic Law or Anti-Superstition Law. It is the government of Karnataka. Namami Barak Festival was recently celebrated where? It was celebrated in the Barak Valley in Assam, and Barak River is basically a part of the Surma Meghna River system. So Assam, Sarbanand Sonowal is the CM and Jagdish Mukhi is the governor. Assam has Dibru-Saikoba National Park, Sonai-Rupai National Park, Manas Kaziranga Orang, and Guppy is the mascot for All India Boxing, that AIBA Boxing Championship that will be held in Assam, Guwahati. And Assam, you can also know that ASEAN probably will open the consulate office of all the 10 countries at Guwahati. And governor is Jagdish Mukhi. Which city has hosted the first ever APCERT Open Conference, which is basically for Computer Emergency Response Plan? This was recently held in New Delhi. What was the 2017 theme for the World Toilet Day, which was observed on November the 19th? The theme was wastewater. Which state government has recently given its approval for setting up a state Ayush society? This is given by Bihar. JDU party is the ruling party along with BJP. There is a coalition, and deputy CM is Modi, Sushil Modi, I mean. And the chief minister is Nitish Kumar, who became CM for the sixth time. And Bihar has Valmiki National Park. And governor is Satyapal Malik. Who will head the 7-member committee that has been set up by the government of Maharashtra to recommend the ways to stop the custodial death? Custodial death is a big issue, often overlooked. And Mr. Aniket Kothale, he recently passed in custody in Sangli in Maharashtra. And the chairman of this committee would be Mr. Sudhir Srivastava. So that was the third week, part one. I hope you are enjoying the coverage. Study IQ, and please share the videos as much as you can. Thank you so much.